every person should celebrate his or her birthday, in my opinion. It's a date that you gain the breath of life. And then after your birthday, I think it's important to celebrate the day that calls you to understand what freedom was for your forefathers. For many people, that's going to be the 4th of July, and that means something to me. But for African Americans as a subset of society, it is Emancipation Day, which is Juneteenth.
June in Texas, it's always been hot.
I want to tell you a story from way back.
They have a little band from the church. Every church had bands that they got from the mortuary. And that's how people cooled off, but it was hot.
Whether it was gospel music, jazz music, R&B, the blues, when you celebrated and had picnics or you're at the church, you had all kinds of music.
Barbecue, red soda water, watermelon, yes.
To elevate and celebrate the foods that people used and not take them in the negative tone in which they were perceived. Watermelon was a staple.
And my uncle raised watermelon, so we look forward to that.
Really, you had to have red soap if you're going to have a true Juneteenth celebration. And of course, you would have that with some type of barbecue.
Was a day in which you'd eat a lot of good watermelon, more than you would normally eat. You'd have great barbecue, far more than any of us should have consumed.
Even the ice cream was homemade.
It was a day of just having fun, frivolity. But my mother would always work in some time to make sure we understood what we were celebrating.
Our celebration was basically like a family-oriented celebration. We would have, you know, speeches, you know, the deacons from the church would, you know, talk about the importance of Juneteenth. Start off with prayer.
That had to come first. Now, it doesn't mean that you didn't do other things, but that was first.
Back in the day, there was no electricity, and it was truly in the country with the smokehouse, the well, the outdoors toilet.
It was big to us back then to go to the country for the Juneteenth celebration.
Family, fun, food, and freedom. As the history of Juneteenth continued decade after decade after decade, and here we are in 21st century, and we're celebrating Juneteenth, that meant that some people had to hold on to it. They had to grab onto it. They had to make it theirs.
Maybe when I was younger or going through a certain militant phase, I would rebel against it because I knew it meant that the slave owners got an extra 2 years of crops. And back then, the way you work slaves, sometimes you can get two crops in a year.
There's no shame in the knowledge that came 2 years later.
And regardless of how it comes, and when it comes, as long as it comes, that's all that matters.
I never wanted my children to think or have any part of not knowing who they were.
A lot of people have sacrificed, a lot of people have done, given up their lives so that we can live a better life.
Juneteenth is about the actual emancipation. There was a theoretical signing and a document, but that wasn't the actual emancipation.
A group of people had to work an additional 2.5 years and to try to understand what that meant.
We were taken advantage of, and when I say that, the ancestors of those who are here in Texas.
During the summers. Okay, so we went in East Texas in the summer, and we would pick cotton, pick peas, pick potatoes, and all those things so that we knew how hard it was that they went through the hard times.
From another world.
Juneteenth is fun, but Juneteenth is also something for you all to honor, because people struggled and didn't know they could make it, and some did not. They were slaves. We lived in a time in this country when our ancestors, those that we have descended from, were strapped and lassoed and handcuffed, if you will, with ankle bracelets and otherwise, and they were owned. They were owned, like a purse, like an iPhone, like a car. They were owned. Weeping
and wailing. We as a people really need to go back to our heritage, because this is what brought us.
Yeah.
You know, it's what brought us the community, our people, the churches, what made us a great people.
I think about all that we have gained and all of those heroes and sheroes that symbolize toiling, working, perseverance, determination.
Oh yeah, my kids are to take the day off. They have to be serious about it, not just talk about it, do something about it. And my daughter just told me the other day that she put in her Juneteenth holiday.
Something keeps on worrying me.
When I talked to Dr. King as a teenager, he told me, he said, whatever you do, do something for the people.
Whoa, I know you're around here somewhere. When you come out to celebrate Juneteenth, when you barbecue a thing or two, when you open a pop of soda of some kind, when you have family and friends around, and it's Juneteenth, and you're smiling, and you're laughing, and you're listening to some good music, it's simply a way to say thank you to my ancestors.
So I hope that future generations, in addition to the celebrating and the music and the poetry interpretations, the frivolity and a celebration of freedom, there's also a chance to reflect on just how difficult it was to get to where we are. And a discussion about what else do we need to do.